Hi everyone, welcome to this online class. I'll be dealing with you the first chapter of mathematics, that is about real numbers. Before knowing the definition of real numbers, let us recall the definition of rational number and irrational number. What are rational numbers? The numbers of the form p by q, where q is not equal to 0, and p and q are co-prime numbers, they are called rational numbers. Numbers of the form p by q, where q is not equal to 0, and p and q are co-prime numbers, they are called rational numbers. The symbol for rational number is q. If the HCF of p and q is 1, or if only one divides p and q, such numbers, they are called co-prime numbers. For example, take this fraction 2 by 3. It is of the form p by q. Let me find the HCF of 2 and 3. Before finding the HCF, let me write the factors of 2 and 3. Factors of 2 are 1 and 2, of 3, 1 and 3. Now, let us find the common factors of 2 and 3. Which is the common factor here? 1. And the highest common factor is also 1. Here, HCF is equal to 1. If HCF of P and Q is 1, then P and Q are called co-prime numbers. Or, if only 1 divides P and Q, such numbers, they are called co-prime numbers. Let us learn the definition of irrational numbers. Numbers which are not of the form p by q, where q is not equal to 0, they are called irrational numbers. Numbers not of the form p by q. When q is not equal to 0, they are called irrational numbers. For irrational numbers, we can give one more definition. Non-terminating and non-recurring decimal expansions, they are called irrational numbers. Non-terminating and non-recurring decimal expansions, called irrational numbers. Let us learn about different types of decimal expansions. For that, we need to know these examples. Let us just take this example of 11 by 2. Denominator becomes divisor, the numerator becomes dividend. 2 into 5, 10. 11 minus 10, 1 remains. Put decimal point, this becomes 10. 2 into 5, 10. 10 minus 10, 0. Here you can notice here, the remainder is equal to 0. And the quotient, it is a decimal number. If the remainder is 0, and the quotient is a decimal number, it is called terminating decimal expansion. It is called terminating decimal expansion. Terminate means end. If the division process ends and if the remainder is 0 and the quotient is a decimal number, it is called terminating decimal expansion. Let me take one more example. Let me divide 10 by 3. Denominator becomes divisor, numerator becomes 3 into 3, 9. 10 minus 9, 1 remains. Put decimal point, 1 becomes 10. 3 into 3, 9. 1 remains. Since you put decimal point, it becomes 10. 3 into 3. In this example, you do hundreds and thousands of steps. The remainder will never be equal to 0. It is called non-terminating decimal expansion. If you carefully observe the quotient, after a decimal point, 3 is repeated. Even if you do any number of steps, 3 will be repeated here. After decimal point, if a single number or a group of numbers are repeated, it is called recurring decimal expansion. Here, the type of decimal expansion is non-terminating means division process does not end. Non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Write the decimal expansion like this. Here, number 3 is repeated. Whichever number is repeated, on the repeated number, we put a bar like this. This means this number is repeated or recurring. If it is non-terminating and non-recurring decimal expansion, it is called irrational number. Let us learn what type of decimal expansion the rational numbers and the irrational numbers possess. Rational numbers are either terminating decimal expansions or non-terminating recurring decimal expansions. If it is non-terminating and non-recurring decimal expansion, it is called as irrational number. So I hope you are clear about the type of decimal expansions. These rational numbers and irrational numbers, they are combined or grouped to form single set of numbers. That combined set of numbers consisting of rational and irrational numbers, they are called real numbers. So children, what is the definition of real numbers? The combined set of numbers consisting of what and what? Rational numbers and irrational numbers, they are called real numbers. So in today's class, we will be learning about real numbers. The first concept, whatever you study, is called as Euclid's division lemma. As the name itself suggests, it deals with division. Lemma means it is nothing but a proven statement which is used to prove another statement. Before understanding the statement of Euclid's division lemma, let us take this example. Let me divide 10 by 2. Denominator becomes divisor, the numerator becomes dividend. 2 into 5, 10, 10 minus 10, 0. Here, 10 is called dividend, 2 is called as divisor, 5 is the quotient, and 0 is the remainder. In 9th standard, you have learned law of division. What does the law of division say? Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. If I give the symbol for dividend as A, divisor as B, quotient as Q, and remainder as R. This equation is called Euclid's division lemma. This equation is called Euclid's division lemma. The condition is 0 is less than or equal to R and R is less than B. 0 is less than or equal to R, R is less than B. This means the remainder will be equal to 0, or remainder will be greater than 0, but remainder is less than the divisor. The meaning of this is remainder is equal to 0 or greater than 0, but always it will be less than the divisor. Let us learn the statement of Euclid's division lemma. It says that given any positive integers a and b, there exist unique integers q and r satisfying a is equal to b into q plus r, where 0 is less than or equal to r and r is less than b. This is called Euclid's division lemma. Lemma means it's a proven statement used to prove another statement. The application of Euclid's division lemma is, using Euclid's division lemma, you can find the HCF of 2 or 3 positive numbers. Then that method is called Euclid's division algorithm. Algorithm means it is a series of well-defined steps used to find a sort of problem or used to find a type of problem. Using Euclid's division lemma, if you can find the HCF of 2 or 3 positive numbers, then that method is called Euclid's division algorithm. Now, with the help of examples from exercise 1.1, let us learn how to find the HCF of 2 positive numbers using Euclid's division algorithm. This is the first exercise. Exercise 1.1. The first question is, use Euclid's division algorithm to find the HCF of 135 and 225. It is an important question. They are asking you to find HCF of 2 positive numbers using Euclid's division algorithm. Also, it is very easy and interesting. Of 2 numbers, which is the greater number here? 225. Take that as A. A means dividend. Take the smaller number as B. B means divisor. This is step 1. Greater number is dividend, smaller number is divisor. 135 into 1, 135. 5 minus 5, 0. 22 minus 13, it is 9. 225 is A, means dividend. 135 is B, means divisor. 1 is quotient, which is denoted by symbol Q. 90 is the remainder, which is denoted by symbol R. If you want, you can verify Euclid's division lemma. What is the equation? A is equal to B into Q plus R. A, 225. 225, B 135, Q 1, R is negative. 135 into 1, 135, plus 90. 135 plus 90 is 225. We get LHS equal to RHS. This means whatever quotient and whatever remainder we have got is correct. Now let us move on to the second step. In first step, whatever divisor is here, in next step that becomes A value. First step, whatever remainder is there, that becomes B value in the next step. So repeat, divisor becomes A value and remainder becomes B value. Greater number is dividend, the smaller number is divisor. 90 into 1, 90. 5 minus 0, 5, 13 minus 9 is equal to 4. Let us move on to the third step. You tell me what will be A value next step. This divisor, it becomes A value and this remainder becomes B value. Greater number is dividend, smaller number is divisor. 45 into 2, 90. 90 minus 90, remainder is 0. You can notice here, in the third step, the remainder is 0. What is the divisor of this step? 45. In which step, remainder is 0. Divisor of that step will be the HCF of two numbers. The third step, remainder is 0. Here, the divisor is 45. In which step, remainder is 0. Divisor of that step will be the HCF of two numbers. Therefore, HCF of 135 and 225 is 45. This is about Euclid's division algorithm. To make you understand better, let us take one more example. Let us find the HCF of 196 and 38,220. Greater number is dividend and the smaller number is divisor. This is the first step. Greater number is dividend. The smaller number is divisor. 196 into 1, 196. 12 minus 6, 6. 17 minus 9, 8. 2 minus 1, 1. Bring down 2. 196 into 9. 9 into 6, 54. 4, 5 carry up. 9 into 9, 81 plus 5, 86. 6. 8 carry up. 9 into 1, 9. 9 plus 8, 17. Borrow 1, 12 minus 4, 8. Borrow 1, 15 minus 6, 9. 7 minus 7, 0. Now in the next step, whatever divisor is here, that becomes A value. whatever remainder is here, that becomes B value. 98 into 2, 196. 196 minus 196, the remainder it is equal to 0. You can notice here, in this second step, the remainder is equal to 0. In which step, the remainder is 0. The divisor of that step will be the HCF of two numbers. In second step, remainder is 0. Here the divisor is 98. So HCF of 196 and 38,220, it is 98. Now, I'll give you a problem for homework. Using Euclid's division algorithm, find the HCF of 867 and 255. In the same way, using Euclid's division algorithm, find the HCF of 4052 and 12,576. Dear students, based on whatever concepts I have taught, there will be certain number of questions wherein you may have to answer. It may consist of multiple choice questions or 2 marks or 3 marks questions. You may have to answer online and you have to submit the assignment.